trumpets play? All the trumpets play? Saxes, all saxes play the tuning note.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We would like to welcome you back to Lakeside Performing Arts Center. This is our first concert in over 15 months. Oh. Thank you to our stage manager, Mr. Bird, who just blinded me. I appreciate that. No, I'm kidding. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Henry Hartman. I'm the Fine and Performing Arts Supervisor. And I haven't been as busy this year, and I've been depressed because we've missed all of the concerts that our kids put on each and every year. And when we were going through the pandemic, our directors and the kids really wanted to have that opportunity to perform. So tonight we were able to bring all of our ensembles that we have at the high school level are going to be performing tonight. We have some groups that will be performing here in the pit. Others will be up on stage, and we'll try and make our transitions as quickly as possible to get you home to watch the Sixers game, if that's what you choose to do. And if not, that's okay. We'll play as long as we can. I would like to thank our directors. We have Miss Donna Terry, our senior high choir director. Mr. Matthew Adams, our memorial choir director. Mr. Rob DeSantis, our senior high band director. And Mr. Joe Sino, our memorial band director. He's floating around here somewhere. So these guys have been dedicated all through the pandemic. For some of you that don't know, there were a lot of schools and districts that just said, we're canceling our music program. And nothing has happened in their schools for the past 15 months. We have done everything that we can to take the necessary precautions to make sure that your kids are safe and to continue the program going in Millville. So I'm very proud of everything that they've accomplished over the past 15 months. And I'm glad that, again, we're able to bring you this presentation tonight. Do I have to kill more time? Some of them know my jokes, and they don't want to hear the jokes. So as you guys were walking in, I said that it was nice to see half your faces. You guys can decide which ones I did want to see and which ones I didn't. All right, never mind. Are you ready? Miss Terry, are you ready? Mr. Adams is ready? Excellent. What are you waiting for? Come on, let's go. Because you want to hear them more than you want to hear me. So please give it up for our memorial choir.
actually all singing in person together. A lot of our students and our choirs attend our class virtually, and we hear them singing over Google Meet, and there's always a 1 or 2 second delay. So what I'm singing, they sing like 2 seconds later. So tonight is so exciting that we actually get to hear a lot of our kids together in person at the same time, not through a computer screen. So it's so very, very exciting. So this group is our senior high chamber ensemble, and we are so blessed to have an awesome jazz band to work together and present Sway. Thank you so much. That was so much fun. We're bringing up our concert chorale and our chorus members to perform the very solemn, not solemn, but beautiful Billy Joel song, And So It Goes. On this song, we have three soloists that will be featured, but they'll stay in their spots on the risers, and that is Mark Green, Brian Ballard Jr., and Cassidy Miller.
Thank you. My cheat sheet. This is a very bittersweet time of year. It's sweet because we're in person together and we're performing live music. And it's a little bitter because we have to say goodbye to our seniors. This group of seniors, I had a lot of them were in choir with me when I was at Memorial their sophomore years. So I've known them for at least 3 years. And there's a few that I knew when they were little wee ones at Holly Heights Elementary, so it's super bittersweet for me to say goodbye to some of them. So I'm going to call their names, and I just want you to give a nice hey when I mention your name, and just know how much you're appreciated. So our seniors are Brian Ballard Jr., and hold your applause if you can till the end, okay? Sorry. Brian Ballard Jr., Jared DeShields, Bishop Giddens, Sir Hadley, Taylor Hastings, Tyler Lonabell, Cassidy Miller, Thomas Music, Melissa Nunez, Nevin Ojeda, Tashina Romulus, Shelby Sager, and Aiden Thoden. We have Jalen Kane, Aracelis Cruz, Cassidy Green, Sky Howell, Jasmine Smith, Anaya Williams, and then Alexandra Rivera, Morgan Poland, Ashley Ripa, and Kaylin Smith. And she's, and of course, I have Kelsey. Martinez was one of mine from Holly, and so was Thomas, right? And Jalen, right? Sorry, Kelsey, because you're there. You're on my list. I love you. And then I want to recognize our seniors that were, or our students that were in South Jersey Chorus, if you can just raise your hands. Okay? And then our students that were in Allstate as well. We have two that were in Allstate. Takes a huge commitment to be part of these regional choirs. Lots of Saturday rehearsals. This year they were virtual rehearsals and virtual auditions. So now comes the time for our National School Choral Award. And this very special senior was a member of the South Jersey Regional Choirs for 3 years, and then the All-State Mixed Choir for 1 year, and I'm very proud to present it to Sir Hadley. Blossomed as a vocalist and a performer, and no matter what mood Sir would be in, he would always come into the choir room with a smile on his face. I want to miss that smile, so I want a picture so I can hang it on the wall so I can still see you. All right, at this point I'd like to bring up any alumni that are here. If you would like to sing The Road Home, we're going to dedicate this to our seniors and alumni. The only thing we ask is that you kind of stay on the ends and then you keep your masks on, okay? So if we do have any alumni, you may come up at this time.
Thank you.
That also featured Taylor Hastings as the soprano soloist. Let's hear for Taylor. At this time, our last selection before we combine all of our memorial and senior high choirs is Somebody to Love. Soloists will be Natalie Harrison and Nevin Ojeda, and we'll feature some of our jazz band members in our rhythm section. Matt Phillips on set, Will Shea on bass, and Daniel Laird on keys.
Somebody
On the electric guitar. Thank you for your talent. All right, to close our choral program, we are bringing up our choirs from Memorial and our consecralin chorus from Senior and Chamber. You guys are good for the day, all right? So you guys can come down to the audience and watch. And we're going to bring up our other choirs and finish out our choral portion of the program. Our first selection will be Lost Boy, and will feature Jasmine Baldwin, Aracelis Cruz, and Kaylin Smith as our soloists.
On the run from All we ever want is auto all of the time.
Maybe we can find a place to feel good, and we can treat people with kindness. Find a place to feel good.
Madison Gallagher and William Milbourne were the two soloists.
Thank you so much for being here. We are going to present four virtual pieces. The first was a collaboration with Vineland High School entitled Give Us Hope, and it was done in the winter months, and the Vineland High School choir director and our choir directors collaborated on it. We taught our kids it, and we put this virtual recording together. And then the next three will feature our instrumental program. And our band directors will tell you a little bit more about them, but they're fabulous. Okay, so enjoy the rest of the virtual part.
Thank you. Etched on a granite wall below a grave at Arlington National Cemetery, one can read the following words. And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. My fellow citizens of the world, ask not what America can do for you, but what together we can do for the freedom of man. John Fitzgerald Kennedy was born in Brookline, Massachusetts on May 29, 1917. Jack, as he was often called, was the second child of Joseph and Rose Kennedy, and together his parents raised 9 children. He attended Harvard University, where he graduated with honors. In World War II, he served in the Navy and commanded PT-109. When the ship was sunk, he risked his life to save his crew. Serving his country helped to shape his thoughts on the future of America's right to defend its freedom. Let every nation know, whether it wishes us well or ill, that we shall pay any price, bear any burden, meet any hardship, support any friend, oppose any foe to assure the survival and the success of liberty. Let the word go forth from this time and place to friend and foe alike that the torch has been passed to a new generation of Americans. JFK was the youngest man elected to the office of president. He was the first Boy Scout to become president. John Kennedy was the first Roman Catholic president. He was the first president that served in the Navy and the first to have earned a Purple Heart. The main challenges of his term in office were conflicts with Cuba, Russia, Vietnam, the Mafia, and concerns regarding civil rights. Hear the words of newly elected President Kennedy as he prepared to face the uncertainty of what would surely become his lasting legacy. In the long history of the world, only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. I do not shrink from this responsibility. I welcome it. President Kennedy was an ardent supporter of the civil rights movement. He, along with noted activist Martin Luther King Jr., worked long and hard to help bring about positive change. On June 11, 1963, he addressed the nation and proclaimed the following thoughts. This nation was founded by men of many nations and backgrounds. It was founded on the principle that all men are created equal and that the rights of every man are diminished when the rights of one man are threatened. I am therefore asking the Congress to enact legislation giving all Americans the right to be served in facilities which are open to the public, hotels, restaurants, theaters, retail stores, and similar establishments. This seems to me to be an elementary right. Its denial is an arbitrary indignity that no American in 1963 should have to endure. In the fall of 1963, President Kennedy turned his attention to his re-election campaign and decided that a trip to the South was long overdue. With First Lady Jacqueline by his side, he embarked on a 2-day trip that would take him to 5 major cities in the heartland of Texas. On the morning of November 22, 1963, a motorcade of political dignitaries traveled along a 10-mile route that wound through downtown Dallas. Since the earlier rain had stopped, the plastic bubble on top of the presidential limousine was removed. Overflow crowds of excited people lined the streets and waved frantically to the Kennedys. At approximately 12:30 p.m., the car turned off Main Street. As it was passing the Texas School Book Depository, gunfire suddenly rang out in the plaza. Let us reflect on the events of that day and remember that life, as we knew it, was about to be changed. Two of the three shots fired struck the president, causing him to slump over toward Mrs. Kennedy. The limousine sped off to Parkland Memorial Hospital, located just a few minutes away. However, doctors could do little to save him. A Catholic priest was summoned to administer the last rites, and at 1 o'clock p.m., John F. Kennedy, the 35th President of the United States, was pronounced dead. For 4 days, the world stood still while people from all walks of life mourned the loss of their beloved JFK. On November 25th, he was laid to rest. As people struggled to make sense of a senseless act and to articulate their feelings about his life and legacy, many recalled these words from his inaugural address. With a good conscience, our only sure reward with history, the final judge of our deeds, let us go forth to lead the land we love, asking for his blessing and his help, but knowing that here on earth, God's work must truly be our own.
Okay, so a virtual peace, what does all of that mean? Well, 15 months ago, we didn't know either. In most of the pieces you heard, students were at home on their computer wearing a set of earphones that basically gave them just a click track, maybe a little bit of accompaniment. They would record that, they'd count through their music, they would play their parts, and then they would send everything to their directors. And then the directors had the daunting task of taking 15, 20, 30, 45 individual tracks, merging them all together, so it created what you saw tonight. So I know that our directors learned a lot over the past year, especially when it came to mixing, editing, and just lining all this music up so that it sounds good for a performance and a presentation. So again, I'd like to thank them for all of their extra hours and hard work of putting all of that together. So besides virtual, there's a couple other things that go right along with virtual. We have some of our kids that have been virtual the entire year, and they're performing tonight with the group for the first time. A lot of the virtual-only kids are at home, and they're listening to the rehearsals. They're participating where they can from the living room, or their bedroom, or wherever they can find that's a little bit quiet. But some of them are performing for the first time along with their classmates. I feel like wherever I am, I'm in the way here. And then the other thing that's been nice about virtual is we are actually streaming tonight. So if we'd like to say hello to all of our friends who are joining us wherever you are. We hope that we have a lot of likes and comments and whatever else goes along with that. But that's going to be something that we're going to try and continue with as a Fine and Performing Arts Department, is streaming our events out. So if you have family or friends in other states or can't make it to the concert, hopefully they would be able to check it out either at a later time or during our live stream. We do record all the performances also, so we should be posting the links afterwards so that you can go back and check out the performance again if you'd like to. All right, our band looks big, doesn't it? It's amazing what social distancing in a band can do. So we have a bunch of groups that are going to be performing for you from the instrumental side, and thanks to the guys who have been back here helping us get set up so that you're not sitting here for 20 minutes just saying, oh, another chair, another chair, another chair. All righty. We're getting closer. We're pretty close. All right. What else? Anybody else want to know anything about the past year and a half? It's been a blast. So other changes that are happening, I guess it's okay for me to say something, but I will no longer be the K-5 supervisor for Fine and Performing Arts. My job responsibilities are changing next year, so I will strictly be 6-12, music, art, world languages, and math. It naturally goes together, yes. Okay, I'm out of material. D said he has plenty to keep you busy and entertain you. So let's hear it from Mr. DeSantis.
Thank you. Let's hear it from Mr. Hartman. He's been outstanding this year to help us out. We appreciate it. Yeah, this year's been challenging to say the least, but I can't say enough about these students. They're amazing. Everything we said, we got to wrap you in bubble wrap and put masks on you, and they were like, okay, that sounds good, whatever, let's do it. It was awesome. It was very, very refreshing, so we were very excited to do that. We're going to need like 2 or 3 more minutes to get these guys up. I appreciate your patience, and then we'll be ready. All right, symphonic band, you can come up and go in front of the percussion section and then all the way on this side. Some of the virtual ones forgot how to do things, we gotta tell. Yasmin, this is live people right here. Yeah, it's great. Getting my steps in. We're almost there. Look out, Melvin. I'm gonna jump over you. Okay. We did it. But just to prove to us that we can do it better, we're just going to do it again. Yeah. That was the longest intermission ever, wasn't it? Yeah. But we did it. All right, so the first one is our senior high school concert band. The concert band is small but mighty. They're right here in the front row. We had a blast. And there's also Chris back there on the guitar. He's also in the room. Wow. Chris, you didn't tell me this. All right, this one's called Escapada. It's also featuring Mr. Sino. Mr. Sino, by the way, did all the video editing for the virtual pieces. He did an outstanding job. Also helping out the concert band was Matt Phillips on the snare drum back there. I don't know where he went, but he was helping out, yeah. So up next we have the Memorial Band, accompanied by the Senior High School Concert Band. I'll face you since I'm talking to you. Conducted by Mr. Sino. Mr. Sino. Thank you. All right, this next group playing is the Senior High School Symphonic Band. We meet every other day throughout the entire year. They've been really fun. Their first block, we're playing Loud and Proud at 7:40 a.m. Even the virtual people, sometimes they are on their pillow and we have to wake them up, but that's okay. But these next two are the Symphonic Band, The Voyage to the Edge of the World and Sleeping in the Place of the Stars.
Seniors stand, that's all I need.
All right, now's our time to honor the seniors. Like Ms. Terry said, these seniors have been through a lot, we can all agree, and they've come out stronger than ever, and we could not be here without their help, so we appreciate all of your leadership to get us through all of this. I'm going to have the seniors stand, and if you could hold your applause till the end. Megan Hallenbeck, Cassidy Miller, Rosalyn Rodriguez, Abby Sorrentino, Olivia Scarpula, Daniel Laird, Alex Locke, John Smith, and Michael Parmer, our seniors, class of 2021, and Aurora Ryan. Sorry, Aurora Ryan. Sorry. All right, have a seat. Yeah. We also get to hand out an award. And our award is the John Philip Sousan National Band Award. It goes to a senior member of the band every year. It's very difficult to choose every year because we have outstanding seniors all the time. That's the amazing, great part about the job that we have. So we're surrounded by great seniors all the time. This one in particular has gone above and beyond, has auditioned for regional ensembles, has gotten leadership positions, has gone to colleges and performed with them, has taken private lessons. So it was someone that kind of stood out, even though there was a lot to choose from. But this year's award goes to Rosalyn Rodriguez. And our final piece is Sleeping in the Place of the Stars, and then we will transition into some more combined pieces.
Before we jump to our next piece, My Solo Canvas, I just want to say a few things. One, hi. That's pretty much the first thing. There's live people in front of me, and it makes me very happy. That's all I want to say about that. Two, yeah, be happy, be psyched, be hype. We are going to jump into a piece called My Solo Canvas, just a little bit of a backstory on this piece. I'm actually going to read it from the blurb. He wrote it pretty good, so I don't want to reword it. In an effort to convey an impression of someone who unfortunately took their own life, this piece represents feelings of solitude, loneliness, but as well as confidence, determination, and conflict. As more personal connection, the central theme's rhythm is built on the name of a student that this was written about. Solos for the instrument she played, which you're going to hear actually done by the entire section for flute, and her love of nature and art. Not to be forgotten, the pain and grief of those who are left behind is also represented. This is a very beautiful piece called My Solo Canvas. But before I play it, I just want to point out, at Memorial, we do give out a director's award, just like Mr. D gives out the Sousa Award and the Louis Armstrong Award for jazz. It's extremely difficult to pick a person throughout this entire COVID stretch of a year, whether it's in person or virtual. It's been extremely difficult on students, teachers, parents, everybody. It's getting feedback. Going through what we're all having to go through and talking through these masks and teaching. So it's always great to come to band every morning and find that, I might be too loud. Or I'll step back a little bit. Or not, never mind. It's always great to find our students in the morning. It just gets me so hype. It gets me so energized for our day. So this director's award is going to someone who is in the Memorial Band, has been in the band for multiple years, has a lot of energy, always a smile, always says hello, and always really focuses and shows and exemplifies what it means to be a true band's person. Not a band's man, but I guess a band's lady. This year's award, just a round of applause for Stella Shepherd. You may stand up. There's a plaque on the wall at Memorial, and that we laser engraved the names on there for that. Forgetting one other thing. Ooh, one last thing. I wasn't going to say this, but there's a really cool quote. A teacher stopped me in the hall today, and just kind of a mental thought as we go through our few pieces to finish off the night. He said, I'm going to quote, give credit to it. Chad LaSalle, if you guys know Mr. LaSalle, he's at the senior high, he's floating around, does a lot of stuff. He said, music is a sixth sense in that throughout, with missing live theater, with missing live performances, right, Broadway coming back in September, and this is like our first concert in like over a year, we don't realize how much, like you listen to a piece of music, some will get you, some won't, but you get like those goosebumps when you get to a really cool spot, right, when you're driving in the car, and we don't realize how much music is a part of our life until we lose it. So it's so important that we have this here. This is why us teachers come to work every single day. So it's really a big deal that this is back. Thank you. And without further ado, My Solo Canvas.
Thank you.
Let's hear it again for all these band guys up here. Great job. We have one more transition for you into the jazz band, and then we're all set. So thank you again for your attention tonight, and I will scoop my way down and continue. Mr. Bird, could you put a little bit of the stage lights on? Just the front ones? Just a smidgey? Yeah, that's great. Thank you. We failed to mention Mr. Bird, our stage manager back there, helping us out always. Great job. Thank you so much. All right, this is the jazz band. They meet on the opposite day of symphonic band, every other day for the whole school year. They are a blast. Some of the things we say in this, they are weird people, but they're all the good kinds of weird, and it's the great way to start the day. We're wearing sunglasses, is that true? That's what I hear? It's bright down here. Where were the cool kids? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Kenny, you got your shades? Can't forget your shade. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right, first one is A Night in Tunisia. Alex Locke on trumpet, and Bryce Bernetta on the trombone. best kind of weird, you know? You heard from Andrew Zara on that last one. You heard from Austin Davis. This next one's entitled Work Song by Aurora Wearing a Work Hat. We had plenty to spare around the high school, so we found one. on saxophone. Aurora Ryan had a sax solo. Austin Davis had another solo. Yeah, good job. All right, this next one has the funniest name, called Goomba Boomba. I don't know. Actually, it's by a band named YMA Sumac. Anybody a YMA Sumac fan? Mrs. Laird, I was counting on you, to be honest. Yay! All right, good. Alex Lopp is already standing. Daniel Laird, our seniors. And just like Symphonic Band, the jazz band has its own national award, the Louis Armstrong Award as well. Tough group to choose from again, and this is not the easiest thing to do, but this person has gone way, way, way beyond anything that we could have ever asked for, has led the band in many ways, even though they didn't think that they were, has changed instruments several times, has made all state band, and is an incredibly, incredibly big shoes to fill when they leave. But a huge, huge congratulations and thank you to our Louis Armstrong winner, Daniel Laird. Next one, and then the last one is called Big Noise from Winnica. I would like to thank all of our teachers, Mrs. Terry, Mr. Adams, Mr. Sino, our supervisor, Mr. Hartman. And, all of our administration, our principal, Mrs. Rose, this is her last concert as principal. We thank her for everything she's done for us. Mr. Bird, our stage manager, and thank you to all of you for all your support in the arts to make this possible. As Mr. Hartman said, this is not going on in every place, so we're fortunate to work in a place where it does. So thank you to all of you. This is our last piece. I appreciate you all coming, and thanks again.
Thank you all once again. We appreciate it. We'll see you soon. Have a great summer.